Hey guys, welcome back to Taste of Victory. I'm TasteARC, and today we got a great possible budget deck for you guys to play in the Booster Set 4 meta that can still compete. I got third at Locals with this just this weekend, and I got some really good competitive games in Huang Zero's Charity Mon tournament that took place Sunday. I'm not sure the actual placement since it was a for fun charity tournament, but there were some intense games in there. So right now, prices are going down with the hype of Booster Set 4 for the old sets. So right now is a really great time to pick up a lot of these old set cards. And one of the decks from Booster Set 1.5 that can still compete very well is Imperial Dramon, blue-based Imperial Dramon. So why is that? Because looking at this list, we see that a lot really hasn't changed. But the big thing here is the new Lobomon card. This card says, for the cost of 2 Digivolution, you may Digivolve this card from your hand onto one of your blue tamers as if the tamer is a level 3 Digimon. So the main strategy of blue Imperial Dramon is to more or less OTK or one turn kill as it's known. So you can't truly do it all in one turn, but you can take large chunks of your opponent's security away with the right combo because an Imperial Dramon over a Paiute Dramon can swing for potentially 3 times in one turn and it has jamming. So really you're only ever worried about options like Gaia Force and security. So your odds to get all 3 checks off are incredibly good. Because of this, you're leaving your opponent either like at 1 or 2 or 0 security and then it's their turn, or like you don't have another swing on board. But the thing is, you played Davis early, right? And this acts as the rookie. Since you played it a previous turn, it doesn't have summoning sickness because it's like if you played a Digimon a previous turn. So you can Digivolve into Lobomon and then you can sneak away that one last attack you needed for victory. So a lot of opponents are not ready for that and not playing around it. And even if they are aware, it's hard to play around it because what can you do? There is literally no tamer removal whatsoever in Booster Set 4 game as of now. So they're kind of just hoping to go wide enough with blockers to be able to stop your Lobomon. So that is why it's really great to now able to close out games that it could possibly before had a little bit of trouble with, because you need that one extra bit of momentum. So let's go ahead and get into the actual list. First up, we got the babies. We are running 4 Demi Devimon because this card is amazing. When attacking, once per turn, if this Digimon has jamming, trigger, draw 1. So many things in this deck have jamming. Vimon has jamming and it's a rookie, so you're almost always going to want to go over that and get that draw off. Paiutramon, Dino B, Imperial Dramon, they all have jamming, so you have a lot of opportunities to draw off this Devi and Vimon to keep up card advantage and to keep digging for what you need. Honestly, depending on where you are in the board state, a lot of times swinging your Vimon into a blocker, if all you need is a specific card left to win, swinging into a blocker and knowing you're going to die just to get that extra draw and hope to see it is not the worst option in the world. Next up, similar in that vein, we have Upamon. When one attacking, once per turn, if your opponent has a Digimon with no Digivolution cards in play, trigger draw 1. So this is great because it plays into the same strategy of Demi V, except a different condition to meet, which also isn't that hard because a lot of the time you'll be going into kind of rookie rush mode with these little guys down here. So a lot of opponents desperate to keep pace will be hard casting blockers and stuff, and then you get your free draw off of Upamon that way. So a tech that I was testing out was the other Demi Devi, and that was, Demi Vimon, my bad, was this one. I was testing it because once per turn, your turn, when this Digimon becomes unsuspended during your main phase, it gets plus 1000 DP. So my thought was, in matches where it's kind of hard to get past blockers like Megazoo, you could swing, somehow restand with your second board, and then now you'll be at 13k, able to beat over their blocker. But it really, truly never comes up. This card really is not that good, and you just want the extra Upamon for that extra draw power. Next up, we're going up to our rookie lineup, and we are running 14 rookies. A nice healthy number to make sure you're always opening with at least one most of your games. So the first one is going to be our 2-drop vanilla Elecmon. So he's pretty self-explanatory. 3k, 2 to drop, gives you huge advantage. Always run it since it's a free Digivolution anyways. Next, we got 1 Gabumon. On play, trigger, draw 1. And that lets you keep up hand advantage even though you are hardcasting a Digimon, because normally you wouldn't for hardcasting it onto the field. But because of its ability, it lets you keep advantage pretty nicely, and a lot of times an opponent will leave you at 2, so you could choke them with 1 at 1 with this 3 cost to play. Really great card, just swinging him most of the time anyways, expecting him to die since he's only 1k DP. And next up we got 1 Gomamon for the Inheritable. On deletion, gain 1 memory. So this could come up a lot of times, like if you need that, if you got choked at 1 and you happen to have 2 stacks out, and you need that extra memory to Digivolve into X Vimon over this Vimon to be able to restand for game, you could Digivolve into one of your 1 cost champions, swing, expect to die, gain that memory, and then attack Digivolve from that extra memory you got. So Gomamon's a really nice tech because of that. So this is my in real life list because at the moment, I don't have multiple of these cards. I literally, for some reason, only have one copy of these guys. So I would suggest upping either of these to two. Like if you want to take down one Goemon to put two Gabus and vice versa, you can do that. It's up to your preference. I'm just running that weird lineup because that's all I have IRL right now until I get to trade around at locals. But I say Gabumon's probably more important for the hand advantage because you have so many ways to draw with all that other stuff. But this is very clutch. It's definitely up to personal preference which you would like to go out on. And if you even just want to run these two like this at one, that's also very good. Next up, we got Vimon, another self-explanatory card because he has jamming, which means this Digimon can't be deleted in battles against security Digimon. And he's a rookie with only 2,000 DP, so that is huge. That is so huge to be able to swing right away early game with a rookie, not worrying about losing it. And then you can Digivolve into XVmon to restand it and not worry about it getting swung back at. Or you can just Digivolve up high enough that you don't worry about them having a high enough DP Digimon to even be able to swing over. So Vimon's fantastic. Paired with Upamon, he has unbelievable advantage with your draws. Fantastic card. Absolutely max it out. No reason not to whatsoever. And our final rookie is another 2-drop vanilla because it is only 2 to play. Huge advantage. 3k DP. Really great. You just want those bodies to be able to go wide with your cheap cost. Moving on to our champion lineup, I've expressed before how I think 12 is the absolute magic number to be running in of champions in any deck. But if there's a deck that could get away with it, it is absolutely blue. They could get away with less. So if you want to run 11 champions to make room for something else, that's definitely possible since a lot of the time you're rookie rushing it anyways while you're digging to get up to your top end of Imperial. So first off, we got one Gorillamon. So why only one Gorillamon? Why not four Gorilla, four Tobio? Because one Digivolution cost is insane. You could definitely make the argument to up Gorillamon. Like you could put Lobomon down to 3 and put Gorilla up to 2 because yes, one cost to Digivolve into a champion is huge. The reason I'm doing this is because I always want to see Lobomon because there's a lot of games where I literally just need that one swing to be able to close the game because of the nature of Imperial Dramon being able to swing so many times. And there is very little your opponent can do to play around the Tamer that's on the field even if they know it's coming. So I always want to be able to see Lobomon. Because of that, I had to make some sacrifices to Gorillamon. I did run at 1 just because I do want that extra higher up number of 1 cost Digivolution champions to be able to climb cheaply. Because it also, not just to climb, it also helps you dig when you need just that 1 card to win. So yeah, 1 Gorillamon just so I have more than only 4 1 cost of Digivolve champions. You can definitely play around with that number to up it more because 1 cost of Digivolve is huge and never a bad thing to have more of those champions. Next up, we got XVmon at 3. He has 2 cost to Digivolve into, 4,000 DP, and when Digivolving, unsuspend one of your level 4 or lower Digimon. So often, as I already mentioned, you're going to Digivolve this guy over another rookie to, or even over itself to Digivolve to unsuspend Vmon. So typically the play is you Digivolve Vmon in your racing area turn 1, you'll play out a 2 cost rookie to not give your opponent too much memory. You'll Digivolve this rookie into XVmon, and with its effect to unsuspend one of your level 4 lower Digimon, you will unsuspend Vmon, and now you have 2 free draws. Or not 2 free draws, because this is only once per turn. But you have 2 free swings, so without absolutely any worry. The only worry, again, is options like Gaia Force, which seems to be going down in popularity unless you're playing against like Red Yellow Security Zoo, which is definitely a threat. But yeah, that is an amazing combo with XVmon, and it's not limited to Vmon. Don't be afraid to use it on others, because if you swing with like Electmon, 3k DP is not bad. You know, a lot of people run 2,000 DP or 1,000 DP rookie. So if it survives, cool. Digivolve XVmon, restand that guy, swing again. Or Digivolve it over Electmon and start climbing back up again. So now your opponent can't swing over the rookie that should have been vulnerable because of XVmon. It's a fantastic card that you could use for aggression or defense. Vmon is absolutely unbelievable. I think 3, I cut it to 3 so I can make room for that extra Gorillamon because that one cost Digivolution, I told you already how I value it so much. I think it's a really nice sweet spot, but if you want to guarantee those combos, feel free to up it to 4 copies. And then for a Tobiumon, because not only is Tobiumon a 1 cost of Digivolve champion, you also get a 3 play cost, so that's crazy, because if you like come back or like you got blown out by your opponent or you're bricking, you could just play this guy for 3 and you can already go into Imperial next turn. It helps keep up a lot of advantage and it's really amazing for hard casting. And then only 1 cost of Digivolve into, which we've expressed very much, is incredible. At any time you could see it. It is only 3,000 DP, so do keep that in mind. You're most likely going to be wanting going, if you can, go into this guy in the breeding area so that he is safe because he will be removed by a lot of the DP minusing abilities Yellow has in this meta, and Yellow is one of the most popular decks. So you're going to have to keep that in mind when playing around with Tobiumon. You could definitely cut into this guy and run more Gorillamon. I just really value that 3-drop to be able to come back from bricks. So next up, Lobomon, as I said before, his ability to sneak win games is incredible, and I always want to see him, so I'm at 4. So he is at 4. You can just digivolve him over your Davis. Because Davis sets you to 3, you'll always be able to go into him. There's no shenanigans, it'll play with the 3 memory Davis gives you, and he's great for closing out games. I love Lobomon. Next up, we got Pyotrmon. So Pyotrmon has jamming, so once again, you can draw with him off of Demi-Vimon Inheritable, and he's free into security. And the main reason we run this guy is because it's when attacking Inheritable, once per turn, if this Digimon has Pyotrmon in its name, unsuspend it. So what you do is you swing with Pyotrmon, Digivolve into Pyotrmon. Pyotrmon's effect will restand, swing again, that is 2 swings. The Inheritable effect of Pyotrmon, restand, swing again. Wow, you just got 3 checks on your opponent's security, now they're down to 2. If you have anything else on the field, that's all 4. If you have Lobomon, they're down to 5. And now they're under huge pressure to start coming back from that. Pyotrmon is an amazing card that people love to see. You always want to be seeing that to Digivolve into Pyotrmon. Pyotrmon is amazing. So that is him. He is able to Digivolve over green too as well, since he's a fusion card, a DNA Digivolution. So let's go on to our next ultimate. And that is going to be Dino-Beamon. So Dino-Beamon has piercing, which means when this Digimon attacks and deletes an opponent's Digimon and survives a battle, it can still perform security check as it normally would. And then it also has jamming, which as we know, lets him avoid high DP Digimon and security. So Dino-B is good, but serves a different purpose because he has piercing. So he is able to get around blockers, because a lot of your time, people will try to go wide with blockers to stop you from being able to swing. So what happens here is you will want to swing him. If they have blockers out, they can't block because they're just going to get pierced, and you're going to get the check anyways, removing bodies off their board. Or if they blocked previously or swung previously, you can swing into him and still get those checks. The priority is definitely to go into Dino-Beamon though, or to go into Pyotrmon. The priority is Pyotrmon to get those restands off Imperial, because unfortunately Dino-B does not have that inheritable effect to balance them out. Still a great option though, and the reason we're only running 8 ultimates and these 2 specifically is because they synergize with the effect we're about to see on Pyotrmon, because it is name dependent. And here we go, Pyotrmon. He is 5 to Digivolve into, 12,000 DP, but let's look at his effects. When one of your Pyotrmon or Dino-B would Digivolve into this card into this card in your hand, reduce the memory cost of the Digivolution by 2. So he is often, seeing as these are the only ultimates we are running, he will always be a 3 cost that you evolve into, actually, not 5. And that is amazing to be able to play, to synergize with Davis, so you are guaranteed to go into him during your turn and not pass turn if you have Davis out, so you can swing and get the full value off of those restands. And let's look at his other effects. He himself also has jamming, but also, when digivolving, unsuspend all of your Digimon with jamming. So he does not just unsuspend himself, he unsuspends everything with jamming. So if you have another Vimon out on the field, always swing with Vimon first, because he's gonna live, he has jamming, he is now rested after swinging. Then out comes the Pyotrmon, and you restand your whole board. You restand the Pyotrmon itself and Vimon. And that is huge. A lot of times, if you have that set up, your opponent is done and they can't come back from that, because that is so much pressure, or oftentimes just game. He has 12,000 DP, which is great anyways, but it doesn't matter since he has jamming, so he's not afraid of Onimon and security. Pyotrmon is the only Mega I believe we're running to Digivolve into in this list because of that name dependency and because the name of the game is OTKing with jamming. But we do have 3 other Megas. The thing is, we're not Digivolving into them ever. You could into Dino-B, but there's no reason to, because let's look at Puppetmon's on-play effect. Suspend one of your opponent's Digimon. During your opponent's next unsuspend phase, none of your opponent's Digimon can unsuspend. When attacking, gain 1 memory. So Puppetmon is 11 cost to play, but you gotta ignore that. You got to understand that this effect is unbelievable, because oftentimes, as I've said throughout the video, you just need that one more attack. And maybe you're really low on security. With Puppetmon, you buy that extra time you need for that attack next turn. It is frustrating for your opponent. It is great for you, so you can stall to build up your stack. You can stall for the next turn you need to win. This guy steals games by himself. We run 3, and you can absolutely make the case for 4, because Puppetmon is better the more you see it back to back. So I would honestly suggest holding on to your Puppetmon when you see it in hand until you've got another, because a lot of the value from Puppetmon comes from being able to play them back to back and keeping your opponent locked down to make sure they don't do anything. Yes, you're giving them 10 memory if you're playing it at 1, or like 7 if you're playing it at any other higher memory. The point is, you're giving them a ton of memory. But if they can't make do with it, if they can't attack with that Digimon that they're playing out, what's the big deal? Yellow, it's a little more dangerous, because then you can Digivolve up into Shine or up into War Greymon, and in or into slash rather and DP minus your board to clear, so it's not as bad for them, but you are still able to clutch it out. And then when attacking, gain one memory is really great because it is able to help you reach thresholds for memory that you need to be able to play Digivolutions, be able to broadcast Digimon, you know, other plays to be able to clutch, close the game out. So Puppetmon is fantastic. Three is really good optimal number. You can definitely make the case for four. And then we got Ray of Victory. So Ray of Victory is my personal tech. That is main effect, return one of your opponent's level 5 or lower Digimon to their hand. Trash all the Digivolution cards of that Digimon. Then if you have a blue tamer in play, unsuspend one of your Digimon. And security effect is activate this card's main effect. You always love to see free effects in security. The reason I run Ray of Victory over Kakaita's Breath is because it is a sooner, cheaper Kakaita's Breath. I hate Kakaita's Breath. I think it is awful removal, and the only reason we're running it is because it's the only removal we have. Blue has to run it. Ideally, I would not though. I'm running Ray of Victory because it does the same for less and earlier. A lot of the times, like for example, into like yellow, oftentimes we'll be committing to a stack early game because you got that Rise Greymon to play something out, or you got War Growlmon to DP minus and stuff. So a lot of the times we'll be single stacking your game. So if you play this at three, you'll leave them only at two if they don't have their tamer out. And that leaves them hard, like an empty board, because now they have to Digivolve all the way back up. They don't have, oftentimes, another stack that just Digivolved into the level 5 you bounced. So Ray of Victory is a really cool momentum card for that, especially from security. And then from security, it's unbelievable because you don't even care about... I mean, it helps the first effect in security, but in security, the unsuspend is huge to protect your Digimon if they decide to swing to security before trying to clear your board. So it's a really nice spicy tech, and I definitely suggest you guys try it out. Next up, we got for Hammer Spark. It's literally gain one memory. Why on earth would you not run it for free? And then security gain two, huge. That could literally swing you games because it'll pass turn to your turn while your opponent was planning something. And then finally, to round out the list, we got Davis Motomiya. So Davis, start up your turn. If you have two or memory or less, set your memory to three. So that is fantastic to make sure we got enough for all our big plays. And then on play, reveal the top three cards of your deck. Add one blue and one green Digimon among them to your hand. Place the remaining cards at the bottom of your deck in any order. So we want to play Davis out anyways to get the memory and then to have something out for Lobomon to Digivolve into. So that bonus to search your deck for what you need is great. Because early game, you could potentially unbrick by that digging. And late game, if you just really want to see your Imperial, where are you? You can dig for the top three with him. So Davis is fantastic for that. Really great card. Three, because I really just feel any memory tamer at four is really bricky. And by the time you see all three of them, or rather even just one, it's done its job and you have what you need out of it. And the reason we run three is to be able to see it rather than I actually want to see more than one. I just want to see it at all. I think four would be bricky. So yeah, this is the Imperial Dramon list. Let me know what you guys think if you test this out. I've been testing it out throughout this weekend. It could definitely still compete with the Booster Set 4 meta. You just gotta know what you're playing into and adjust accordingly. I love it. It's fun. You hit face. It's great. Let me know what you guys think. And until the next video, remember to stay hungry until you get a taste of victory.